the blessing of the greenery and wreath. Cedar and evergreen branches are placed as signs of royalty because Jesus reigns as King. Wreaths and garlands of evergreens are hung, reminding us that Christ's reign is eternal. May all the greenery of this season remind us of the one who lives and reigns forever, Jesus, who is our Lord.
The blessing of the Advent wreath. May this wreath constantly remind us to prepare for the coming of Christ, that the Christmas season is filled us with peace and joy. As we strive to follow Jesus' example, let us pray. Loving God, your church joyfully awaits the coming of its Savior, who enlightens our hearts and dispels the darkness of ignorance and sin. Pour forth your blessings upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May their light reflect the splendor of Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen.
The lighting of the first candle, which is the candle of hope, and a reading from Isaiah 60, verses 2 and 3.
For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn.
We light this candle as a symbol of Christ our hope. May the light sent from God shine in the darkness to show us the way of salvation.
O come, Emmanuel.
Chrismon tree, let us be reminded of the one who brings light to our darkness, healing to our brokenness, and peace to all who receive him. Let us pray. Blessing of the Chrismon tree, Holy Lord, as we come with joy to celebrate the birth of Jesus, who rescued us from sin by making the cross a tree of life and light. May this tree, arrayed in splendor, remind us of the life-giving cross of Christ, that we may always rejoice in the new life that shines in our hearts. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray. God of every nation and people, from the very beginning of the creation, you have made manifest your love. When our Savior, when we are needed for a Savior, was great, you sent your Son to be born of the Virgin Mary. To our lives, he brings joy and peace, justice, mercy, and love. Lord, bless all who looks upon this manger. May it remind us of the humble birth of Jesus and raise up our thoughts to him, who is God with us and Savior of all, and who lives and regenerates forever, regenerates forever and ever. Amen.
Today's gospel lesson comes from the gospel according to Mark, the 13th chapter, verses 24 through 37. Jesus is speaking. But in those days, after that suffering, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in the clouds with great power and glory. Then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near, at the very gates. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going on a journey, when he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each one with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn. Or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Do you enjoy preparing for big events, for holidays such as Thanksgiving? Did you enjoy preparing for that this year? At our house, it was very different. For many years, we have traveled to be with family, either my family or Ron's. And this year was the first year in 10 years that I've cooked a turkey. Usually, I only have to do a couple of side dishes, but I cooked it all this year, and it did not go as planned. I shared with some of you that turkey was not thawed when I put it in the oven. So at about 9 o'clock that night, we had a bite of turkey because it still wasn't cooked when I took it out, and I put it back in the oven on Friday. But as I was doing all this cooking and preparing, I thought about how simple Thanksgiving was when I was a child. I might have to set the table or wash dishes, but that was about it. And what I realized is that it really takes someone preparing for the celebration to be what we want it to be. If we really want to enjoy that good meal, somebody's got to do the preparing. In the passage that I just read from Mark, Jesus is talking to his disciples about being prepared for his return. And we read that passage today because Advent is a time when we not only celebrate and prepare for Jesus' birth as we celebrate his birthday, but a time when we remember that we're also waiting for the return of Christ. We're waiting for Jesus to come again. Jesus tells his disciples that they are to keep awake, to watch and to wait for the Messiah to appear. During Advent, we prepare for the birth of the baby again. But at the same time, we are waiting in anticipation and expectation that Christ will come again. It's Jesus himself who tells us to keep awake, to watch for his coming, and to be prepared. For many people, this time is only about celebrating Christmas, about celebrating Jesus' birthday. And what are the preparations that we make for that? Our preparations here in the sanctuary were a little different this year as we tried to spread out when people would be in the room. And so several people came at different times to help decorate this year. In our homes, we're decorating. And at the offering time, you're going to see a little short video with some of the pictures that people have sent us of their holiday preparations. And we do things like decorating our homes, we bake, we plan for the gifts, we plan for the meals. And those are actions that help us in the waiting. I think about when I was a child, there wasn't a lot to do except perhaps go Christmas shopping, maybe decorate the tree, but most of the action took place with adults. We just kind of went along for the ride. And so waiting was hard. It was hard. When we're waiting on something to happen, it's much easier when we are actively doing something to help us pass the time. Because waiting can be hard. And it certainly seemed like it was a long time to wait when I was a child, from the beginning, from Thanksgiving until we opened those Christmas presents. It seemed like a very long time. These days it seems very short, like there's not enough time to fit everything in. Waiting's different when we're excited about something, when we're looking forward to it. And it's much different when we're dreading what is coming. When we are hopeful about what the future will bring us, we are much, it's much easier to wait when we're waiting with hope. And that word hope has really struck me as important this year for us. I need hope this year. And hope is not something that's just given to us. It's something that we have to cultivate. It's something that we have to choose in our lives. Hope isn't just wishful thinking or optimism. Rather, hope is what we have when we trust in Jesus. And when we keep alert and watch for Jesus, watch for God's action in the world. Hope is something that might be harder to choose when the world seems pretty dark. In the passage that Ron read from Isaiah, we see a people who were hopeful even in a situation where things seemed pretty hopeless. Many of them were living in a foreign land and unable to freely practice their faith. And yet Isaiah says, we have been like those whom God does not rule, like those not called by God's name. The great, powerful acts of God seemed like they were in the distant past. The crossing of the Red Sea, the receiving of the tablets, the great flood, the burning bush, all of that seemed like a long time ago. And the people yearned for God to break in again, and they had hope that it would happen. They were hopeful that the Messiah would come. Perhaps many of us can relate to how they were feeling, though, as far as it seeming bleak and dark. We are living in a time when perhaps we're not very hopeful about lots of things in our waiting. As we're waiting for Christmas, we are also waiting for a vaccine. We're waiting for the opportunity to get that. We're waiting for a time when our lives are not controlled by this disease. I long for God to move in powerful ways. If you ever watch Music and Devotions and Ron prays, listen to his prayer. He says the same thing almost every prayer I hear him pray anymore, and it has to do with asking God to eradicate this disease. There is a great desire and a longing for that to happen, and it feels like we are only waiting for it. Do God's powerful acts in your life seem like they're in the distant past? Do you long for God's inbreaking presence again in your life? Are you hopeful? Are you expectant? Sometimes we do look around and we feel more despair than hope. And it's easy to feel hopeless when we think things are so bad. I do long, as Ron does, for God to step in and take care of it. Jesus tells his disciples not to lose hope in a situation that might seem hopeless. In this passage, he tells a parable about a man going on a journey who leaves his servants with tasks to do while he is away, and he commands the doorkeeper to be on watch for his return. And at the end, he leaves this admonition, therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening or at midnight or at cockcrow at dawn. That just means any time during the day. Or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And I say to you, as I say to all, keep awake. Part of what's going on there is the servants are to be about the master's business while the master is gone. To me, this speaks a word of hope. When the master's gone, we're not to just sit down and give up, but we are to keep doing the things that Christ has called us to do. And not just to sit down and wait, but to be active in our waiting. And that brings me back to where I started in all these preparations that we do for celebrations. I'll be honest, when it comes to Christmas, I am a procrastinator. I am that person that you see in the store 2 and 3 days before Christmas buying all their Christmas gifts, because I might have purchased one before then. I love it. I love being in the store with a crowd of people. I love that Christmas rush. But this year, I know I can't do that. I know that I will, this coming week, be sitting at my computer looking for what I want to purchase whether I order it or order it and go pick it up. I'm not sure yet. Everybody hasn't told me what they want yet. They know me. They know it's usually right before Christmas, but I need to be better prepared this year. I need to prepare myself in all those secular ways, but I also need to prepare my heart and my life. The servants were told to be prepared, to be about the master's business until the master returned. I want to spend this Advent waiting in hope for God, looking for where God is acting, and searching out how I can be a part of that, how I can help to meet the needs around me. Think about the time in your own life when you have done something, like whether you've gone to a shelter and served a meal, or when you've gone to visit someone who maybe was sick, and you came away from that feeling, I think I got more out of that than they did. I can't tell you how many times I've had someone tell me exactly that, how much more of a blessing they have received in doing something for God than perhaps the person receiving it had been blessed. There are things that Christ asks us to do as we wait. So as we anticipate and wait for the arrival of Christmas this year, and as we wait for Christ's return, we are to watch for God's action in the world and see what we can do to join in that. What are the things that you need to do this year to prepare for Christmas? Not necessarily your home, but your life, your heart. Is it that you need to reconcile with a family member? Is it that you need to make this holiday more pleasant for someone who might be less fortunate? Is it that you really need to commit to looking for God and where God is acting now? How can you wait with hope this year? Watch for God. Keep alert. Let us pray. Gracious God, we know that you made your love real to us through the birth of a baby so very long ago. Might we know the power of your love made real in our lives this year, at a time when the world around us seems dark and foreboding. May we place our trust and our hope in your grace and mercy and love. Show us again the tasks to which you have called us. Help us to see the ways in which we can make your love real to others during this season. As we wait and as we prepare, may we truly watch for your presence among us. May we truly work to be your heart and your hands in this time and place. Lord, there are so many people that are hurting right now, and many who feel hopeless. You know that hurt. We know that you see and hear the cries for help. Lord, show us how we can reach out that we might be an answer to someone else's prayer. And Lord, you know the needs and the concerns that each of us carry. We lift before you those things. We particularly ask that you would heal those who are sick in body and mind and spirit, that you would restore them to wholeness. And Lord, we especially lift before you those who are mourning the loss of one they love, someone whose chair is empty now. Might they know your comforting presence, bringing them peace and hope. We pray all these things through Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I would remind those of you that are in the room that the offering plates are at the doors. For those at home and joining us virtually, we invite you to send your offering to the church. We're going to watch a little video, and I need to explain the very beginning of it. I asked you to send some pictures of decorating your home. There are a few pictures of that that some folks sent us, but the beginning of the video shows what happened, a few pictures from Wednesday. Some members of our church on their own decided to help feed a family in need, and so there were some folks here cooking on Wednesday. We had two families that lost loved ones, and there were folks here preparing meals for those families as well, and we had Elder Bless folks here playing. So you'll see a few pictures of those things to remind us of the many ways that we are reaching out to our community, that we are in ministry in this place. And so then there's some decorations, some close-up of the sanctuary for those who are not here in the room so they could see those a little better, and then some pictures from our homes. When that finishes, I'll say a short prayer. And I want to say, if you didn't send me any pictures this week, send me some in the coming weeks, and probably on the 20th it will be a special service on December 20th with some special music. We hope the kids will be presenting a pre-recorded little pageant that day, and perhaps we can show some more of your celebrations, of your decorations, and the ways that you're sharing this holiday. So if we want to go ahead and watch that video. Let us pray. Gracious God, we ask your blessings on our preparations in our homes. As we decorate, might we remember again the symbols of this season, the wreaths and the evergreens that remind us of eternity, and candles and lights that are symbols of your holy light that shone through the Star of Bethlehem. As we place nativity sets in our home, may they truly remind us of the birth of Christ. Lord, while we prepare our homes with decorations, might we also prepare our hearts for you. Bless all those who look upon the decorations, that they might see your light and your love in our celebration of Jesus' birth. And it is in his name that we pray. Amen. I invite you to join in singing, "Let All Mortal Flesh Keep Silence."